Harvard also cares about people who are just genuinely kind. If you print it out, it's 10 pages. Chintu ke mummy ne kaha ki Chintu ye kar raha hai. HSC, IB. Namaste, my name is Avanti Nagral, and I just graduated from Harvard this past May. I am part of the class of 2020, and I graduated with honors with a degree in psychology and global health and health policy. I also did a dual degree with the Berklee College of Music, but I will talk about that in another video, which I will link at the end of the description. One of the biggest questions I get asked is how to get into Harvard. And agar main sach bolu, no one knows. And the reason I say this is because for every 1600 student ka class that they admit, they could replace us with another 1600 students who applied and you wouldn't be able to tell the difference. One of my favorite characters, Edna from The Incredibles, says, "Luck favors the prepared." I love that. And I try to live by that. So here's a few steps on how you can prepare your Harvard application. Marks, test scores, subjects kya lene chahiye, itne sawal aate hain iske bare mein, so I'd love to address this. Do marks matter? The answer is yes, but only so much. Marks are the gateway to get your foot into the room. If you have a certain level of marks, you're great, you're golden, and you're like everybody else. What does that certain level of marks mean? It differs for different people. Either it means you are consistently in the top 10% of your class or in the first decile. I was in the first decile all through high school. I got mostly 90s. It can also mean for some people that you've significantly improved, that maybe in your 8th, 9th standard, you got less marks, but by the time you went to your 10th, 11th, 12th, you really improved, and people love to see improvement because it shows that you've put in hard work and effort. But beyond that, once you have a certain level of marks, it doesn't matter if you came first or second or third or fifth or seventh. You did well in your marks and that's all they care about. So in that case, which system should you look at? Is ISC important? Is HSC, IB? Honestly, it does not matter. What they really, really care about is jo bhi aapka system hai, have you taken the most out of the system? Have you taken the most rigorous classes you could have taken? And have you done your best in that system? Because no matter what system you come from, whether it's HSC, ISC, IB, whatever it is, CBSC, you're all ending up at the same place. And think about it, there are students from all over the world who all come from different systems. I personally did ICSC until the 10th standard and I did ISC 11th and 12th. And I did the science stream, but instead of physics, I took psychology. So many students and parents ask me, kaun se subjects lene chahiye, math lena chahiye, ye lena chahiye. And the subject you take does not matter. You do not have to take STEM subjects to get into Harvard. You just don't. What colleges really want to see is people with diverse interests who come into college. So if you really, really, really like sociology, if you really, really, really like computer science, pursue that. Don't pursue what everybody else is pursuing or what you think somebody else did. Isne ye subjects liye aur isko admission mila to mujhe bhi milega. That's not true at all. In fact, they're always looking for different kinds of students. It really doesn't matter the nature of the subject you take. What matters is how well you do in the subject. It doesn't matter whether you take the SAT or the ACT. Whichever one you think you'll do better in, try that. Even with the scoring system, once you have a certain baseline score after a point, it doesn't matter. The reason they have you take this is because it's the only standardized test across all the systems all across the world where they can kind of gauge your aptitude. But remember, the SAT and ACT are not tests of your intelligence. They are just tests of, honestly, how well you can take a test. So the better you prepared you are for that, and once you get a certain baseline score, you're golden. I got 2370 in my SAT and I got 800 in both my SAT 2s. My honest opinion is if you get over 2250 out of 2400 or whatever that equivalent is now on 1600, you're fine. There's no need to keep retaking it and retaking it and retaking it just to get a high score. Because think about it, they don't take everybody who got a 2400 on 2400 or a 1600 on 1600 because it's not just about marks. When you apply to the US in general, but especially to a place like Harvard, marks matter, but they're just your gateway. And that leads me to point number two, extracurricular activities. I can't tell you how many people ask me, ki kya extracurriculars karne chahiye, kya ECs karne chahiye so that I can get into college. I would really encourage you not to think about your extracurriculars as something you do to get into college. I would rather honestly encourage you to say, what is it that I love? What is it that I love doing? And think about college as one step along the journey and path. In my example, I talked about a lot of things that I was passionate about, but primarily music and global health. I'm still living and breathing that today. I'm a full-time musician, got a degree in global health. I do work in both spaces. It was not just a college project to get into college. It's something I genuinely cared about. It's something I genuinely wanted to make a difference in. Just because somebody last year got in because they did this coding project in this field, or somebody else built a robotics project and they got in, doesn't mean that that's going to make you get in, because these admissions officers have become very smart. They know when you're doing something just to get into college, and that's not going to impress them. They would rather care about somebody who's really passionate about something. Let's say aapko video game khelna bahut pasand hai, aapko PUBG khelna bahut pasand hai. That's great. How do you use that and talk about that and use that as something meaningful? Do you create communities around that? Do you think about how you might want to create video games in the future or do something? Think about the design aspect of them. Whatever it is, that's just an example, whatever it is, they care, whatever you've done, have you taken it to the next level? And is it something you truly and passionately care about? Because that will come through in your work. On your application, you'll have a place where you can list out all your extracurriculars. And there's 10 slots. A lot of people will just try to fill in all 10 because karna hi padega. 10 hai to 10 fill kare. If all 10 are meaningful to you, please fill them out. I filled out all 10. But if all 10 are not meaningful to you, I've seen so many applications where people have just put anything in their 8th, 9th, and 10th slot so that it looks like they have 10 things. Don't do that. What these officers care about is you can have 5 things, but if those 5 things are really meaningful to you, they are unique to you, it'll make a world of difference. And I have a solid reason for saying this. I'm suggesting this because when these admissions officers create a class, they are not looking for everybody who is super smart and does computer science. Otherwise, that's all the class would be filled with. They instead are looking for people to fill up a diverse class. So there is space for somebody who cares about gender equity. There is space for somebody who cares about cooking or video games or music or dance or research or science or you name it, there is space for that. And it'll come across as authentically you if you genuinely put in the effort and do whatever it is that you like to do. And please do not do something kyunki Chintu ki mummy ne kaha ki Chintu ye kar raha hai aur Chintu ki behan ne ye kiya to they got into Harvard. No. You are unique and you, I promise you, will have a much, much, much greater chance if you do something that you're truly passionate about. The next thing that's really important is your personal essay or your personal statement. Some schools like Harvard will also have a supplemental 1 or 2 extra essays, but there's always this primary essay called the Common App essay. And you can write about anything you want, but let me give you a few tips there. Your essay is the only place that they can genuinely hear your voice and what it is that you like to do. Every other part of your application, if you print it out, it's 10 pages, it's paper. It's a list of things you've done. It's a list of achievements, but it's not really your voice. Your essay is really the place that you can tell your story. It's really the place that you can talk about what's been meaningful to you, why, how, and how that's shaped you. Don't start an essay with a quote. As the great Rudyard Kipling once said, don't be cheesy. It's meant to be more conversational. It's meant to be something that somebody can read and they get to know a little bit about your life story. I've read many other friends' essays, and the most common theme, whether they were writing about wearing shorts instead of pants, whether they were writing about their older sister and the impact that she had on them, whether they were writing about their love for football, it all came back to them. And that's the most important thing. It's about you and your life story. The other thing is when you're writing your essay, don't tell, instead show. Paint the picture for them as if you're painting a scene. Instead of saying, I helped my friend do this thing, describe that scene, describe the setting, and then describe the lesson afterward. There's a resource called www.essayhell.com, which gives you a lot of tips on how you can show instead of tell people what you want to do. The next piece that is super important is your recommendations. You can get 2 recommendations from teachers in school, 1 from your school counselor, if you have a school counselor, and then you can get from a couple of people outside. Your recommendations are so important because it's the only place in your application that you have somebody else's voice vouching for you. I remember talking to my admissions officer after I got in, and she said one of the things that set my application apart was the type of recommendations that I got. It wasn't because they were from some big fancy people, but it was because the people who wrote about me knew me so well and knew me not just as a student and not just as somebody who did well in their classes, but as a person and as a human being, and they were able to talk about that. So make sure when you choose your recommenders, you are choosing people who can talk about you as a person. What I would suggest is whoever you identify as your recommenders, write out a list of things you would ideally like for them to touch upon. For example, let's say it's your English teacher and your English teacher is also in charge of your school debate and you took part in a school debate competition that really changed you. You can mention that, so that's hopefully something they can bring up in their experiences. Have a conversation with the people who are recommending you and make sure that they are all able to talk to slightly different aspects of your personality. Because if they know you super well and they're able to vouch for you and your human qualities, that makes a world of difference. Because in addition to looking for people who are passionate and want to make impact, Harvard also cares about people who are just genuinely kind and who are just genuinely people who make a difference in their own small community, whether that means on a classmate, on a teacher, on a parent, or anybody else. And when you have other people talking about that, it allows you to not come across as bragging, or it allows you to not apni band baja rahe ho. You're not doing that, somebody else is doing that for you, and that makes a world of difference. Make sure that you try to get a recommendation from somebody. So in my case, I got a recommendation from both my Guruji and somebody I'd worked with in a professional capacity. I've performed on stage a lot, so who had seen me in different shows and was able to talk about not just my performance skill and level, but my dedication to the craft, my hard work, what went on behind the scenes, because that makes a world of difference. So make sure you get all of those things together. And lastly, if you have a school counselor, invest the time to get to know them. Because the more that you get to know them, the more they get to know you, and the better they will be able to talk about you as an applicant and as a person. So recommendations are extremely, extremely important. Moving on to supplemental material. So if you are a performing artist in any capacity, you do music, dance, sculpture, art, jo bhi hai, there is a separate place you can share links or videos or pictures of your work. It's called Slide Room. It's on any of the application portals. And that's super important. For me, I sent in a few performance videos, and from what I understand, it is Harvard will take that and forward it to, say, their music department, or for a visual artist to their art department, and vouch for whether that is actually at the skill level that you talk about. So if I say I am at X skill level, that department will be able to quickly verify whether that is true or not. If you are somebody who's done research, you can attach a research paper there. If you are somebody who has gone on an expedition and you have a video about that, you can do that. Anything that's visual, anything that's not written that you want to add as supplement, definitely do that. And if they give you an option to add any other supplementary additional information, please, please, please do. In the time of Corona, that is more important than ever to explain your situation. Let's say you're in a situation where one of your family members has passed away or people have been affected. That will allow you to explain a lot of things which no other place will. And I wouldn't waste your time writing an essay about that as your main essay. Use the supplemental areas to be able to talk about that. Lastly, let's talk about financial aid. Harvard is one of the only universities in the US that is need-blind for international students. What that means is, regardless of whether you're an international student, US citizen, any citizen, you will be allowed the same amount of aid as anybody based on your need. So if your family is earning X amount and they think that you can't afford the full tuition, they will meet you halfway. So you can get anywhere from 100% scholarship to 50% to 20% to 10%. So all in all, I hope this has been helpful in breaking down the components of your application and breaking down how to be a little bit more prepared for each one. Generally, I would suggest making sure you are prepared a few months before the deadline. You start working on your essays, you start reaching out to your recommenders, Because the later you wait, the more hurried everything will be and the more shoddy your application will be. Jitne jald se aap shuru kar sakte hain, the more time you'll have to think about it, the more time you'll have to really put it together and make it something you're proud of. Please let me know if you have any specific questions. If there's enough questions in the comments below, I will film a question and answer video. Feel free to reach out to me on any of my social media. My name is Avanti Nagral, and you can find me with that name, either Avanti or Avanti Nagral, on every platform. If you liked videos like these and you would like to see more, please do not forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, hit the bell notification. It'll help you see this content easier. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a great day.